Welcome back, you're watching Logo. Over the last couple of weeks, we've been getting you a special series called Connecting Bharat on how the growth, opportunity and potential seems to have gone beyond cities into rural towns and villages. But one segment which has not quite benefited from that entire spread is the Indian retailer. What's gone wrong? We caught up with a couple of them to find out the answers.
Multi-store formats, city malls, shopping centers and sprawling complexes offering food, shopping and entertainment all under one roof is a common sight in metros like Mumbai and Delhi. With time, increasingly, retailers and marketers are experimenting with cities outside big metros. Tier 2 and Tier 3 cities are the ones which are gaining importance.
Rural, we haven't reached yet because but I have to admit that Tier 2 and Tier 3 cities, so we are in Patna, we are in Jammu, we are in Chandigarh, we are in Jalandhar, and these have been surprises. They, in some cases, they've done better than Delhi as a city, so they've been absolute surprises.
The emergence of Tier 2 and 3 cities, infrastructure improvements, increased consumer exposure to global brands, and preference for shopping in newer environments, availability of quality real estate and mall management practices continues to propel retail growth beyond metros. Rural India, on the other hand, is yet to experience the comforts of organized retail. As numbers indicate, only 10,000 of 6 lakh villages in India have access to organized retail. It seems like for some major players, rural India still poses challenges which need to be overcome before any investments are made.
We would love to be in rural India, but we have a phased approach to open our stores. Our strategy is a little different than other retailers because our category requires a lot of after-sales service. And it is important to look after the housewives who are our number one customers. Suppose a fridge breaks down in rural India, am I in a position to provide her the service on time, is the question.
The rural growth potential is huge, especially now with increased employment opportunities through programs like NREGA, higher purchasing power and increased media exposure. That's probably the reason why players like V-Mart are betting big on it.
Right now, almost 60% of the operations come from the rural market. We are strongly going to the rural market, to the belt of the rural market, and we strongly feel that those cities with a smaller background, with lot of villages attached to it, with lot of rural areas attached to it, is yielding the maximum of the profits, is yielding the maximum of the turnover.
While organized retail takes time to reach remote areas, marketers believe that it's the supply chain that needs to be worked on. Rural population cannot reap the benefit of organized retail till such time that villages get fair price for their agricultural produce. It'll be income that'll have direct bearing on consumption. With eChopal, ITC is aiming to link directly with rural farmers via the internet for procurement of soybeans, wheat, coffee, etc.
No individual agency can viably take products or services to the rural people. So what we've done is created a platform so that other people, and this is an end-to-end integrated solution, so other people can plug and play.
The network of 6,500 eChopal centres spread across 40,000 villages is fast emerging and over 4 million farmers are benefiting from eChopal. As marketers experiment with Tier 2 and Tier 3 cities, they believe the next wave of retail growth should soon reach the hinterland as well. The way to leverage the rural opportunity will be through partnerships with some stakeholders, such as farmers, rural retailers and micro-entrepreneurs, and then delivering to them the advantages and efficiencies of organized retail.
Well, there are lots of lessons to be learned from the eChopal platform and how ITC has actually used it. Moving on, it is a brand that has been around for 4 long decades, but guess what? Nivea is trying to expand its portfolio and target the new metrosexual man. Earlier, my colleague Baljeet Chadha caught up with the marketing head of Nivea to find out why this broad basing.